The horrifying murders of Hannah Clark and her precious young children have left all of us grasping for answers. Finding those answers will take a lot of soul searching and a lot of time, but at least now that effort has begun.
With candles in hand and a murdered mother and her children on their minds, MPs push politics aside. As some find the words many Australians have been searching for.
I think for me it was disbelief and thinking of the fear of Hannah and her children.
I feel really strongly that we have to be able to do better.
Independent MPs Zali Steggall and Rebecca Sharkey are calling on the government to do more to protect victims of family violence. And they say the need is even more urgent in the wake of Australia's horrific bushfire season. Research shows domestic violence escalates after natural disasters.
We may see a spike in need for services and support, a spike in violence towards women. And so I'd like to think the government, state and federal, can be on the front foot.
Was there anything you learned as a family lawyer that you think most Australians wouldn't know about this problem?
It is so much more pervasive than you think, and it goes into every socioeconomic level.
The government has an action plan.
A record $340 million has been provided under this plan for frontline services to protect and support women and children.
We need to review what funding, where are the shortcomings in funding? So what organisations are asking and saying they need more funding?
The crossbench MPs also want stronger anti-violence campaigns shown at major events such as sports games. They say it's a problem worrying women in Parliament across political divides.
And we have many, I think, quiet conversations at the back of the chamber and outside of the chamber on how we will fix these issues.
Fiona Willen, Nine News.